Everybody, what's going on?
What's going on, everyone? Back at it again.
America. May the best candidate win.
Oh, such a close election, too. Feeling like a 10th inning in the World Series, huh? What we got now is Denzel smiling and I'm smiling, saying hi to everybody. We are in the crazy election right now. The decision right now, we got Trump. Well, okay, what's going on? Too close to call. We got, let's see. So Trump is at 244. He only needs 30 more. Oh my gosh.
Yes.
Oof, this is... oof. I think they have all the numbers right. They're just probably playing it for ratings, man, at this point.
Yeah. He probably knocked it out the park already. Yeah. They just get soaking up, you know. Next thing you know, they're just going to slap his face on the screen and just say he won.
Yeah, and then we're going to see all the social media war.
Yeah, he had already knocked it out the park. They're just dragging it on out.
Yeah, apparent winner, Donald Trump. Yeah, so I think that's it. I just got to check the gold prices real quick, see what he did. I think it's probably going to be at 1,300 right now. So gold is at 1331. Has nothing to do, if you guys aren't investors, before today, the gold price was at 1275 and now it's at 1331 and it's up $58. That is historical highs. And the worst part of it, guys, is tomorrow's economy is gonna take a big hit. We'll just go to Yahoo Finance real quick, since we are investors too, since we do daily fantasy sports. That's it. Everything you need to know about the election. So they're not showing you where the S&P and the Dow and them are right now, but right now it is really down. And they're not even posting news on this. I don't think they want to scare anybody. But I have it on my phone right now, and it's telling me that the Dow and the Nasdaq, let's see. Let me go to futures real quick. The Dow was down 800 points. Oh my gosh. 4%. So 4% of, oh my God, trillions of dollars. Okay, all right. Let's move on. How did you do this? What a good time to short. If you guys are shorters, short the American economy, that's a good time to do so. But good news, though, just to end it on a positive note with that economy, I want you guys to all know that there's an invisible hand that will come and balance things out, and we will pick ourselves up because we are Americans, and we have done it before, and we'll do it again. So, moving on to this week, we're going to wait till Denzel gets back a little bit. How did you guys do in week 10? I did decent. I did better than I deserve. I could have done, how many of you guys are like disappointed that Landry didn't get his catches, you know? I was really bummed out with Landry.
Go ahead.
So Landry, man. If I had had Landry, I would have been in top 30 easy. Yeah, I was up at one. Let me pull it up, man. Let me pull it up.
Did you give up on A-Rob?
No, I didn't. Did you?
No.
Okay.
Did you have him in that line? You talking about Landry?
Oh no. This was the morning only. I didn't do any afternoons, but I did do the morning only.
He probably had about 10 on DraftKings then, huh?
Yeah, I think so. He almost got a touchdown. He's 1 yard away, and he didn't pull through.
Yeah, so, I seen that.
Yeah, so
Very nice, though. Very nice. It hurts. So money, man.
Yeah, that was one of the weeks that we were thinking we'd get a repeat from like last year because he supposedly did well against the Jets last year. But anyhow, we got to move on because we all about the following week. And go ahead and let us know how your NBA is doing tonight, Denzel.
Well, my NBA is seesawing, man. We had a couple injuries, and you know, I'm getting burned right now by injury by Alfred Camino. He only played like 2 minutes, scored 2 buckets, and he got hurt into the first quarter, and he won't return. Late scratch tonight, which was Tyson Chandler. That allowed Marquise Chris to start. He had 5 points going into the fourth quarter, I believe. He's pumping it up a little bit. Overall, my cash games are keeping me over the top right now. I'm in the plus right now with my cash games, so good. Nice. good thing I have those on my back pocket. So unfortunately, on DraftKings, it looks like I'm falling, but yeah, like I was saying, you know, Marquise, Chris, he's done. He's doing pretty good for me.
Mm-hmm.
Minimum price, just a little punt. If he can push it up to 20 for me, it'll be pretty nice. The big performance of the night is so far is CJ McCollum. I think he's up to about, let me see, he's up to 52 FanDuel points in the two minutes to go in the fourth.
Wow, 52. That's incredible.
In a tight game, so that's pretty nice. I had him in every line on FanDuel, but on DraftKings, unfortunately, I didn't have him in not one line, and that's costing me, and it's basically breaking me down. But you live and you learn.
Mm. Sure do, especially here.
Man, I can use that 50, 60 points he put up on DraftKings. Oh man, that's gonna hurt. It's probably like a. It's a smaller slate tonight. I think about 6 or 7 games.
Mm-hmm.
That hurts.
Do you prefer it on FanDuel or do you prefer it on DraftKings?
Draft.
They
got their pros and cons, man. They have this multi-eligible positions on DraftKings. They just pushed back out this year and. I have to get a little bit more adjusted on DraftKings because it's it messes with me. I need to just stop playing on draft, not playing. I need to stop taking risks.
Yeah,
I have to take those definite risks. But I'm putting it all together. I'm shaping it all up like clay. So when I get it tight, it'll be tight, man. The only thing I'm doing is shooting myself. I'm a risk taker, man. So
yeah,
you don't have to take as many risks on DraftKings. I see. Mm-hmm. I take 2 and 3 risks, but the thing is, I can do that on FanDuel because you get to pick 9 players on DraftKings. You can only pick 8, and that's something I gotta remember. So
that's right.
That's one less punt I can throw out there. You know. I can't be doing that. I'm trying to break the bank, though. I ain't even gonna lie. It's gonna happen for me, though. But
oh,
I
need
to take those on GPP.
As it has before. I know that. That's just the payout, right? If you got to do those big risks because if you know that you're gonna hit one that's gonna give you what in the nice grands, 1 grand, 2 grand, 3 grand, that weight will be worth it.
Yes.
You know. But we'll move on quickly into this week in Week 10's NFL. So let's go ahead and look at our favorite matchups. So let's. I deeply apologize. Give us 1 second while the screen comes back. And there we are. All right. So Cleveland, Baltimore, that will be a simple game. They got Baltimore up by 10. You can play everybody on Baltimore side, and it'll be good for you. Cleveland side, I think that you can go with Pryor. You can go with Coleman. And you can go with Kessler, too. But they're playing at Baltimore. Baltimore, we saw Baltimore do an incredible job holding down Pittsburgh in the first half.
Yeah, I had last week I had locked in Barnage and McCown.
Yeah.
But then I got that was for my Thursday to Monday. Then I got that hunch that Ben Roethlisberger was playing, and I said that Thursday night, I'm going to plug in Ben Roethlisberger. And
me too. I did that for a million.
It worked out because McCown ended up not starting, number one, because I had McCown and Barnage.
Yeah.
So I did a little adjustments, and at least, because if I would have left it like that, McCown didn't start. So I would have got a big fat zero from my quarterback. So I took the chance on
Big Ben, huh?
Big Ben. He didn't do what I thought he was going to do, and I paired him up with Antonio Brown, and I kept Barnage. So it was just a scenario. I saved myself, though. I saved myself a headache, but I still didn't cash in that lineup anyway. Mm-hmm. So, but anyway, moving on. On the Baltimore side of the ball, Mike Wallace, I was so disappointed, man. Because it's getting late in the season now. Tighten up the screws. You hear me?
Yeah, you're good. You're good. Sorry.
Just tighten up the screws. I tightened up the screws last week. Mm-hmm. I didn't do as many lineups that I normally do.
Mm-hmm.
And I figured I was gonna nail it, and I still did multi lineups, but not as many as I did. And Mike Wallace was kind of like in that pool.
Yeah.
But I still couldn't string up that good line, you know.
Yeah.
So big ups to Mike Wallace. He did great.
Yeah, I was completely surprised.
I think that was a 98-yarder he caught.
Yeah.
And that really boosted his stats. But I'm, you know, going back to him again this week, I love him.
Yeah.
I don't know how much I like Steve Smith, but, you know, he's always in play, especially when healthy.
Yeah.
And a game like this, it's hard to pinpoint who can go off.
Yeah.
It's this team, but Cleveland had been playing hard, and I like to say they have a chance to win this game, Cleveland.
Mm. All right, so then moving on to our first game, it'll be the Rams versus the Jets, and they got the Jets by 2. It's a small game, 40 over and under. Do you have anybody that you like from that?
You said, the Rams versus the Jets. Uh-huh. I thought I overheard the coach saying that Ty Gurley's supposed to get more touches. I mean, come on now. I mean, what do you mean? He's supposed to get more touches. How many touches did he get? I have to go back there and go back and look. But if you're shortchanging him, his touches, you need to give him what he got coming.
Mm-hmm.
But, This Jets defense has been, it's not been living up to its expectations.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And
they're still top 5 rushing defense, so
Yeah, but you can probably see. Yeah, that's what I was getting to. With that Russian D, you can probably see. You can with that. You can see. I can see Britt probably reaching the end zone this game.
Yeah.
And moving the ball.
Mm-hmm. Britt's been pretty good. Like, yeah.
Yeah. On the other side, I mean, with Gurley, I like to see them. They're gonna have to pass him the ball some too now.
Yeah.
I like to see him pass him the ball. It's like the defenses are game planning on him. Get him out there. Get him out there. If you can't catch, you're gonna have to learn. Definitely, you're gonna have to get him involved in the offense though, to help you. They got to. I'd like to see Todd Gurley more in the passing game. So if he's talking about no more touches, I'd like to, for him to add some passes his way, man. That'll be great. I think it'll help Keenum and the rest of the team. But on the
on the tight end sides too, Lance Kendrick was decent too.
Yeah,
he's probably a good value pick.
Did he do good last week?
He did decent. I think he got his last yards, he got 16 points, man. 16 points for DraftKings.
Very nice.
Yeah, he had 90 yards, 7 receptions. He was targeted twice. Two targets in the red zone. But 7 receptions, targeted 12 times, which is pretty heavy.
And going against the Jets, that's something to look at.
For sure. And I said last time, I'm going to make a line while we talk about this, because I don't want to miss it.
Yeah. Going against the Jets, that could be real. That could be real good this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
So he really needs something to open up their offense, man. Because if Tavon Austin gets that ball in a nice spot, he can break it at any time.
Mm-hmm.
And on the Jets side of the ball, good luck with your body, Ryan Fitzpatrick. Because if they get a hold to you, you might not come back. You hurt. He is hurt.
Yeah, he's trying to be Julio Jones, trying to play under pain. Did you see that? I think I talked to you about that one touch. I mean, that one tackle that he got where his helmet flew off against the Browns, and they should have took him out. Coach put him back in. I think he took a couple of hits too. Him and Cam Newton, man. They're just hurting them, man. But who's the backup again? I forget his name now. He was in the game for a little bit.
Yeah, and then they went to another rookie.
Petty, Petty and Hackenberg. Is that the other guy?
Oh, yeah, because what's his name?
When Petty. When
they benched Ryan Fitzpatrick, he got us. What'd he do? Gino, what'd he do? Torres ACL or something?
Yeah, Gino.
He did something, yeah, man. Yeah. Then they brought in the rookie. But, Ryan Fitzpatrick, he hurt. Not his throwing arm or nothing like that, though.
Mm-hmm.
I've been waiting all season for that explosion, that 3-touchdown game for Marshall.
Yeah.
Kind of feel bad for him. It's like Marshall's just bouncing around. I don't know if he's killing coaches or killing quarterbacks or what. But Marshall
has mad love for Fitzmagic, though, man.
He sticks up for his quarterback.
Yeah, he sure does, man. He did that with Cutler too, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
He was happy to be back with Cutler.
Yeah. Last week, Inua, he was missing in action.
Mm-hmm.
Jalen Marshall got a touchdown. Marshall got a touchdown. These guys, you can't really right now. I mean, Forte is consistent, given the opportunity.
Yeah.
None of these guys you could probably, I don't see for cash now at this point in the season, especially with Fitzpatrick not showing no consistency, throwing to the other team. So,
for sure.
GPP options. But they might, I don't know. I'll have to wait a little while and let it marinate to see if I want to run these guys a little bit more.
For sure, this might be an area where they'd be low owned, huh? So if you want to take a gamble, this would be a great place to probably choose players to do amongst that, because the Rams did a good job holding down I forget his name, the running back from Carolina. Oh my gosh,
Stewart.
There you go, Jonathan Stewart. I don't know why I was gonna say Justin Hunter. Stewart was held down, so that's something to take a look about. Like you said, let's let that one marinate throughout the week. This next one should be really interesting. We got Green Bay at Tennessee. Green Bay 2.5. Green Bay's not themselves, man.
Yeah, there's whispers. McCarthy that was on the hot seat.
Yeah.
I don't know. I have to look more into that. I don't believe it, but it, everybody could be on the hot seat. Gotta figure out. I thought he didn't. I don't know if he took over the offensive plays or whatever, whatnot. From a personnel standpoint, I don't see them doing what's right for the team. They should have a running back.
Yeah.
You know, they should.
That's all. I think that's their missing link. They just need their running back.
Yeah, and they should have a running back. And I don't know what they think they're doing. They just throwing wide receivers back there. Okay, yeah, but it's fine. Maybe it's fine. You know, that game when they got hurt and stuff like that.
Yeah,
you got to go next man up. But next week, get you a running back, and they got a running back, and then they cut him. And come on now. So.
I know.
Probably looking into that.
I've been patient, man. I think because their brand, this Packers brand, this high offense, offensive team, that and just they're losing their image, so it's putting them in really, really. Situations where they can't be patient about anything. They need that quick result, And we all know it takes time to develop, man. It takes time to develop. So, but yeah. But the matchups is juicy though against Tennessee.
He's been like I say, they've been on and off, They got it though. They can turn it on anytime.
Yeah.
Just gotta be ready for it.
Yeah.
I really was looking for it last weekend.
Yeah.
But
big shout out to Andrew Luck, man. He did it.
Yeah, definitely did. But on this game,
who do you like?
I'm looking at
I think Mariota would do decent again, and for sure DeMarco Murray too.
I'm looking at they got Green Bay by what, 2.5?
Yeah, 2.5, 49.
I mean, I like Jordy Nelson every week. I mean, it's no secret. I know what they can do. I know he's our race number one option.
And I think we got Randall Cobb coming back this week too. So
yeah, I thought, didn't he come in and sneak in last week and get him a touchdown?
Did he? Oh, I wasn't aware. Oh, he did, huh? Punk.
Threw me for a loop because I wish he could have sat down because I had.
Wasn't aware of that.
Everywhere. And I had Adams everywhere, but Cobb's just decided he wanted to play. But he snuck in there and got him a touchdown. I didn't see that coming, but on the I like Jordy Nelson always. Like I say, they got Tyron Montgomery at the running back. Okay, well, whatever. I think Cook is Cook back or what?
Cooks for the tight end position?
Yeah, Jared Cook, is he back?
He is questionable ankle. I'm not sure yet. Let me see. Sleeper bot.
All them times I've been trying to pick
Cooks.
Richard Rodgers, he just don't throw the ball to him. Or if he does, he gets some drops. But on the Mariota side of the ball, I mean on the Tennessee side of the ball, yes, I'm liking Mariota. I'm mad I faded him last week. He willed the team.
He did, man. I didn't think he was gonna do that. I had him in my Millie lineup.
And you know, DeMarco Murray has been remarkable. He's not gonna be able, you know, every week. And that's what teamwork is all about, man.
Yeah.
You know? He's not going to be able to beast. It's just, you know, he's not going to be able to beast every week, man. Mm-hmm. But I definitely like him.
Mm-hmm.
I like those two this week.
Mm-hmm.
I like those two. And, you know, barring the status of Delanie Walker, he's a nice option. I like that, too. I can't pinpoint the receivers, man. The receivers are nothing more than GPP options to me. You know?
Yeah. Especially now that Randall Cobb's back, they have so many wide receivers on that side. They should have had, you know, they should have stacked up on their running backs too. But
yeah, they need running backs like ASAP. They got plenty bodies to throw the ball to.
Yeah.
They don't got no business cutting no running backs.
Yeah. Rashard Matthews has been resilient this past couple of weeks too.
Right. I'm sadly, I just, like I said, you know, that I hate to jump on trains, man.
Yeah, I don't think
that I'm narrowing my pool down, it's hard, man. It's hard.
All right, so that leads us to the next game, guys. We got Atlanta at Philly. Now, this will be a really interesting game. They have Atlanta by zero. It's going to be 50 points over and under against Philly. So, Atlanta gives out the most passing yards.
Right.
They're the worst in the passing yards they've given. I don't know the yards top ahead, but I was looking at it earlier. And you can go with any one of these three. Jordan Matthews is the same price for DK and FanDuel at $5,900. So, seeing how Jordan Matthews played last week, I don't know if it was Wentz who was just not on his rhythm. But he was able to pull in 88 yards, 6 receptions. This could be the game where he can redeem himself against Atlanta. And it should be a high scoring game. I mean,
so they played Minnesota last week, right?
They played the Giants.
They played the Giants.
Mm-hmm.
The Giants put that defensive line on them.
Uh huh.
It looked like Jason Pierre-Paul. He had fingers this weekend. So he went back there. I guess he was putting his hands on them, but
he sure did.
That's that, you know. I'm hoping he's not hitting that rookie wall, because if anything, he should be able to bounce back this week against the Falcons.
Yeah.
They said Darren Sproles was going to be the primary back.
Uh huh.
I was so pissed when Matthews stole it. Got that touchdown. I'm like, come on, man. I've been picking Matthews, you know, in my GPPs for the last couple of weeks. Then they finally decide they want to name Sproles the primary back. Then that's when Matthews gets a touchdown. I'm talking about the running back.
Yep.
So anyway, if Wentz can use Sproles a little bit more in the passing game, he'd be awesome. And then Sproles, Did you see? He almost took one to the house.
Also. Yeah, I know. He just stepped out. Just.
Man, I had them everywhere.
Oh man, me too, man.
Me too, man. Woo! That would have been a big plus. That would have been a big plus for us, man.
I know. Defense points and his touchdown, man.
Yeah, man. So don't be surprised. Don't be surprised. If he's due. He's due for one. You know, he'll always. Either kickoff return or punt return, he's always due for one.
Yes, he is. He
can go for one at any time.
Uh-huh.
I don't know how valuable picking that defense would be this week.
Oops. Sorry, guys.
I don't know how valuable that defense would be this week.
Might be valuable, though, because Matt Ryan does throw picks, too.
Yeah, he does throw them. He does throw them. And then a tough matchup, I can see Julio just going berserk on a tough matchup.
Mm-hmm.
Just being that Julio that we, you know what I'm saying?
The warrior. The warrior.
When he went berserk against
he went against Tampa,
the Panthers, right?
Mm-hmm. Panthers, too.
So their corners were kind of.
Yeah.
And that's that. If not, if push comes to shove, you know, Sanu, he's seen what he can do. He's capable. So you can probably be on, if you want to take somebody and be on the safe side, you know attention will be on Julio. In the passing game, you probably can sneak in Sanu, and he can probably get you some nice points.
He got 7 targets last week. That's still pretty good.
Yeah.
That's against Tampa Bay.
He's slowly but surely, he's working his way in the fold.
Mm-hmm. All right, so we'll go on to Houston and Jacksonville. Houston up by 1.5, 42 over and under. Now, Bortles was kind of late on that train last week. And Allen Robinson finally came through, man.
Yeah, he caught that one in the back of the bat.
I know. I think it was on a fourth down play, too, was it? Woo!
He saved his owners, man.
Oh, he sure did.
It went down. I think they probably the same price. I think like 67 or 6900 with the targets. You got to suck it up, man, and give him the go, man.
Yeah, just throw it to him, right?
And he came through for us, man.
I didn't have no Allen Robinson this week because I believed that it wasn't going to happen with the Chiefs. I really thought that the Chiefs were going to take care and just like, it was close to just keeping it down to a couple, I think it was just a field goal. Because I think their kicker was missing their field goals too. And I was like, cool, keep it down there like that because the morning slate was really favoring. I was all the way up to this is wishful thinking, but it was I was so excited, man. It was like this is the first time I finally got a nice decent winning, and I was finally in the top 30. Come on, nice. Come on, zoom in. Come on, you can do it. There we go. And I was like, yeah, man, don't let Allen Robinson gets that touchdown. And I'm back in like the thousands. But then I was like, oh, I knew it was going to find its way to balance. But I was hoping that, you know, I'm like, okay, mess with my emotion there. Now make Landry get a touchdown. Didn't happen, though. But FanDuel gives you, FanDuel give it, then FanDuel take it, man. So, okay, but Jacksonville side against Houston. I don't know where I know Houston. I don't know where Houston really stands on the defense side. Allen Robinson. I would like to hope that they're going to be able to bring some consistency this week and maybe him and Bortles be able to connect really, and it's a really good play for for Robinson this week because Allen Hurns is injured, thanks to Allen Robinson.
Right.
So, he tripped on him or something like that, I remember.
Yeah, man.
So, you know, let me check out Allen Hurns' condition.
You know, if he, you know, if he decides he want to miss a game or whatever, then you got
he's 50-50, okay. Uh-huh. Lee was pretty good.
Yeah. Definitely, if he's not 100%, you know, Lee could be a good value pick.
84 yards, 8 targets, 4 receptions. Not bad, man. Not bad. Could do a number against Houston. On Houston's side, DeAndre Hopkins, though, huh? DeAndre Hopkins. They were on the bye last week, right? So these guys should be fresh. Go. So, yeah, they were on a bye week, so these guys should be nice and fresh. Will Fuller is questionable with the leg. Okay. Strong is out with the ankle. So...
I mentioned like 2 or 3 weeks ago, they've been trying to really focus on the tight end on the passing game to open up things.
Yeah.
And I really like Fedorovich or whatever his name is. He's been doing pretty well since they've been throwing the ball his way.
Yeah, ever since week 4, yeah, I'm seeing. Yeah, you can see the numbers go right up.
People have been getting on him though. I noticed in those 2 game slates, I've been seeing his ownership up there about 35, and so that's all it takes. You know, a lot of people sleep on them, but you know, get to looking at those stats. And then I think they throw to another tight end too. I forgot his name. Griffin. How's Griffin been doing?
Griffin has been. He got 3 receptions last week, 34 yards. He's all right for his price.
So he's capable of being a vulture.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
He's getting targets, but the main one over there is main tight end is Fedorovich. Really like him. Definitely. And that might be somebody I'll be targeting in the passing game. Because they can't get the chemistry together. Him and Hopkins, they just...
Yeah, he throws it to Hopkins, but...
He can't hit the home run.
Yeah.
You know, I know...
He keeps thinking he's Megatron or something.
He is throwing it to him, though.
Yeah. He's getting major targets. Oh, my gosh.
I guess. He is throwing it to him. You know, sometimes you'd be like, damn, is that the only person he knows?
Yeah, like the Colts game, 15 targets. The Denver game, he got 12 targets. Last week, he got 7 against, the week before.
It's probably showing that... Fuller is not 100%. Because, you know, that one game, when he first got hurt, he came and played. He said he was going to play at the last minute and just ended up with a 0. And that was probably 2 games ago, and he ain't been right since. I think he ain't been right since he played the Bears. That was
about... You're probably right.
4 or 5 weeks ago, man, he had a pretty nice game, but ever since he got hurt, he ain't been right. So, they got to keep an eye out on his status.
Yeah.
Definitely like Fedorovich. And Hopkins, yes, and Hopkins.
I like Hopkins, man. I got to throw Hopkins in.
DraftKings.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. For the reception, oh, yes. Oh yes, because since he looks like he's gonna be the main receiver along with Allen Robinson, these two might be really good GPP plays. But moving on to the next game, it'll be a nice defensive game. Minnesota and Washington, 42 over and under. Washington by 3. Minnesota, what a game that was, man, against the Lions. Did you get to see that game, Denzel?
Yeah. Well, you know, Stafford, he's good for that. You almost cooked when Stafford got to come back.
Yeah.
In the last dying seconds.
Yeah.
He's really good.
Yeah. Really good. You know.
He's really good in those situations, man. He's been to the pass so many times, and you know, he's really good in those situations. So.
Did he had a fourth down play?
I was back and forth to the
score. I think, because I'm giving him credit, man. I gotta give him credit. Golden Tate finally came through to it, that in the overtime. So
they yak, man, them yards after the catch.
Yeah, right.
That's his MO.
Uh-huh.
He can turn a 10-15 yard pass to a touchdown.
Mm-hmm.
And he just got to get the targets to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Get set up in the right spots. You know, I see them starting to see that consistency since about 2 or 3 weeks ago. If you notice, him on the other side.
You're talking about
Marvin Jones.
Oh, Marvin Jones, yes.
Yeah, it's been somewhat of the Tate show lately.
Yeah.
So, go figure. They're playing. Who they going up against?
The Lions have the bye week now, but we're talking about Minnesota and Washington.
Minnesota and Washington.
Minnesota for Stephon Diggs, incredible reception. If he had him on DK, he had 14 targets. He caught 13 out of the 14, 80 yards. Too bad he didn't get a touchdown, but then that was already, he gave you 13 points of just catching the ball.
Yes, sir.
That's crazy, man.
But that's good though. That's good for them, man. Mm-hmm. With everything that they're going through with the injuries and everything.
Yeah.
That's really good for them. Hopefully they can keep it up, man.
Yeah.
If they can keep that up, I really like, I ain't gonna say that combo, but I'll definitely take me some more digs.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Do you like this matchup against Washington?
Yes, I do. I definitely like this matchup against Washington. Diggs, he's very speedy, man. So, you know, and he's all over the field, so he can be a little pest out there.
Mm-hmm.
Rudolph really sticks. he really sticks out to me, you know, for his touchdown upside.
Yeah, his red zone targets are crazy, man.
Yeah, so he really stands out to me for the touchdown upside.
Did you think that it was Kyle Rudolph too with that rushing touchdown?
It was Ellison.
Hey,
I was like, man, what the?
I'm like, cool, man. Kyle Rudolph gets a rushing touchdown.
I've already taken the damn. Then here comes another one, man. Disappointed with McKinnon, man.
Yeah. I think everyone was on him, huh? Knowing that he was going to start. Well, he only got, like, what, 4 points? Point 4 or something like that.
Yeah, he's one of the ones where he's just going to have to get him a hole and just explode through it and just be gone.
Mm-hmm. Did they switch him around? Did Ronnie Hillman play too? Oh, he did, huh? So, wow, they're sharing it between all 3 of them? Man, that's terrible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but they got to do what they got to do.
Yeah, I understand that. It's good for them, bad for us.
Now, on the Washington side of the ball.
Yeah.
I don't know which defense we're going to see in Minnesota.
Mm-hmm.
But I know.
Think Kirk Cousins gonna do good?
Yeah, they capable of moving the ball. Definitely. I think they're gonna. He's gonna have to find a way to rip that top off, man. I'd like to see one going deep to Jackson, man.
You know,
to open that defense up a little bit. You know, Jordan Reed, he's always in the play.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he's a matchup nightmare.
Sure is, man.
But I'm just interested to see which defense from Minnesota we will see.
Mm-hmm.
And I actually think that, you know, Washington can move the ball. Can Minnesota keep them out the end zone? I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're doing that dual tight end position now, too, with Vernon Davis. As we can see, Vernon Davis got 5 targets, 5 receptions for 93 yards. So he's starting to come around, too, and fit into the system nice. And
that was the same time. And what did Reed have?
Reed had 13 targets, 9 receptions, 99 yards, and 1 touchdown.
In the same game?
In the same game.
See, right, that was an early game. I didn't see that game. So that just adds fuel to the fire.
Uh-huh.
Now they have 2 enormous targets.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got Crowder. They've already established their chemistry in the red zone with Crowder.
Yeah.
And Jackson, he can rip the top off of defense at any time. And with the speed, I think Minnesota would be in trouble this week.
Yeah, because they do have Washington up by 3. So, what the Browns?
I can't pinpoint who I really like.
Yeah.
But I know I always like me some Jordan.
Really? Yeah, me too. Some Jordan, man. Crowder, and you can this is gonna be biased because Vernon Davis was an ex-49er, so, and I like Vernon Davis for his price too, 4,500. If he can just give me 100 yards, I'll be happy, man.
Man, and I was really loving him with 49ers, man. He had the wheels, man.
Oh, he sure did, man. He sure did.
He had the wheels.
He was
fast.
Oh, he got me reminiscing, man. Oh, those were the golden years.
I remember those days, man.
Yeah. He was really
golden.
Gore.
I love that team with that young cap.
Yeah.
Love that team, man.
It will be a while before we see something like that.
Linebackers.
The linebackers were just...
Those linebackers, because they had me, man. They had me hooked.
Yeah. They were a work of art back there, man.
Yeah, buddy, man.
They made me fall in love with defensive games because I was like, your defense against my defense. Again, when Seattle was, when they had the Legion of Boom, man. Woo, that was.
I'm so disappointed in, what's the running back? Is that Alden? He's just staying trouble, man.
Oh, yeah, man.
You know, what's up with that, man?
Dude, he was having such, they had the perfect system for him, man. The Smith brothers, I can talk about this all day. They had it locked down, man. That boy was getting so much sacks. But you know, we only know what we see on camera. We don't know what goes off camera, so it's a shame, you know, it's a shame. You get an opportunity to change your life forever. But it's hard to leave the hood, man. It comes well with you, man. So, the next matchup, I like it a lot, Denzel. We got Denver and the Saints inside the dome. I thought it was Chi-Town, I'm sorry, but Chi-Town, your Bears is going against Tampa Bay, which is also delicious lineup too, delicious matchup too. But Denver, I think this time, hopefully Talib, I think Talib's getting better. I don't know if he's going to play. Let me see. Because he was injured. I think if he had played Monday night, they're not sure anything. Denver's defense probably would have been a little bit more solid. Because they lost two of their, I think, their corners.
Yeah, they did. One thing they couldn't have done, they couldn't have helped that run game. That run game. But you know what, though? I didn't watch. How many yards did Murray have?
Murray didn't have that many yards. He
had that many yards, did he?
He had. Let me bring it up. Let me double check, because I know he had a lot of. Latavius Murray. He had 114 rushing yards. Yeah, I apologize. 3 touchdowns, 13 receiving yards, and with 1 reception. But I know that two of the touchdowns were just from the 1 yarder. So
right, they've been struggling with that D, with that run D all year.
Yeah,
they've been getting laced up all year, and
Mark,
it is what it is with that. But they play the Saints, right?
Yes, they do.
Okay, now look.
The Saints defense is not that great, man. Okay, like if Kaepernick was able to throw 400 yards.
Yeah, but you know, like on the Saints side of the ball.
Yeah.
Now they're sharing. It looks like you got Hightower and Ingram.
Yeah.
Those boys back there sharing. And they're doing well.
Mm-hmm.
As of right now. Drew Brees puts that fear in your heart anywhere. Cause
in the dome especially.
Yeah. He puts that fear in, that opens up the running game. So if they utilize it, their offense will just be way more dynamic. He was just doing it, boom, through the air.
Yeah.
And last week on the pod, I said I actually thought that it would probably be like a Snead and a Cooks game.
Yeah.
Well, you know, and well, it came out. Michael Thomas was phenomenal, man.
Yeah.
So
love that
like
boy.
I already knew it was, and
love
I missed
him,
on that one.
Uh huh.
You know, but no, I had him. But the call that I made last week, it was kind of a bad call. So we off of that. But anyway, man, what a phenomenal football player he is.
He is, man.
He's emerged as the number one. And man, he's only gonna get better. And that will help Snead and Cooks out, if you ask me.
Yeah. There just reminds me of when they used to have Kenny Stills, you know, when Kenny Stills was a nice deep threat when he was with the Saints.
That's the new Colston. Right?
Correct, yeah. Where is Colston, by the way? Is he retired now?
He should be on his way out now. Okay. Yeah.
I haven't heard
him
in a while.
Big ups to Colston too, man. Mm. Great career.
Mm-hmm.
Got a ring too.
Oh, is that right? When he went against the Colts? Oh, I didn't.
Ring.
Dang, he's been in that long? Holy shit. Damn.
Yeah.
Holy shit, man. Yeah. I was not aware of that.
When you
damn.
Like you said, when you walk into that dome, everybody is better. You're better, man. Your ratings go up.
Yeah.
If you were a 75 when you walked in that building, you're instantly like 82 or something like that. Your ratings are 85. Yeah, you're in the 90s. You're an elite player when you walk into that.
Cheat code on, huh?
If anybody needs this bump, it's going to be
Simeons, yeah.
He needs this bump back.
He sure does, man. He sure does. Could be a good week to try to do a stack with him. So
if he doesn't get this bump, they're gonna. No, I ain't gonna say they're gonna fall flat on their face. Okay. I'm gonna be anxious to see though if what Breeze can pull off, if he can make these guys look silly out there.
He sure, because you know last week was a game where it was like scrimmage for them. Even though they were actually giving up a lot of yards, the game kind of went off after the second half. We saw that I don't know, Kaepernick was just, I mean, I don't know if the players, they just got like lazy, or they just lost interest in the game. Kaepernick was just throwing bad balls. He was throwing it at them, behind them, by their feet. And it was just terrible in the second. Even though he got 400 yards, it's still crazy. It's still crazy. The Saints were. I don't know if they're really playing. I know Mark Ingram was. I mean, Mark Ingram was, because he was mad at me. Don't you ever bench me again.
You know, I was watching this pod, the Swole Cast, man. I didn't have not one share of Ingram, and I watched the Swole Cast comes out every Friday. I don't even watch it until that Sunday morning. And man, they gave you everything, man. They
put was it right there, uh-huh, on the platter
for you. And I didn't even eat it, man.
Oh, man.
It just went in one ear and went out the other. Ingram. They was big on Ingram. Watson. For Baltimore, the receiver.
You talking about I can't even think of his name.
Ingram, Wallace.
Yeah, Wallace.
Michael Thomas. They gave you those guys, man.
Oh, really? Wow, that's incredible.
Melvin Gordon. They gave you them guys, man.
Yeah. Duane Harris. Did you go with him? Duane, is that how you? I swapped him in. I put him in there with.
I love those minimum price guys.
Oh, man.
I had him in there, man, knowing he was going to be thirsty for the workload. And
yeah.
He had about 18 or 20 points or something like that, about 18 points at least, last time I checked, and I was just kicking myself because, man, minimum price, you get good value at minimum price like that, man. You got to eat it.
Yeah.
Not too much, but you got to have some, and I didn't have none.
It was my fault too for that one. I didn't. I played him, but I played him in the wrong place. I played him against my coworkers, because I faded Elliot, and I decided to go with Harris. And Harris did if not a little bit better than Elliot. It was still good enough for me to win. Let me see if I can show it to you guys. Possibly zoom in so you guys can see a little bit better. So, I was excited, man, if Darren Sproles got that tough butt. So, I knew Michael Thomas was going to do somewhat. So, I went with Darren Sproles and on Harris. But I knew that Harris would get a nice run against the Saints. Because I know the Saints are just bad in both sides of the defense, the passing and the rushing. So, And San Francisco, you know, they're playing at home. They should get some form of edge. You know, my poor old team. But going back to the Saints, you know, Denver, I think you should really evaluate Bibbs and Booker. If I think they're gonna probably give Bibbs a little bit more work this week. And at his price, it's incredible. $4,600.
Yeah.
$4,600. I already threw him in right there for this next one. Because these guys are going to be target monsters. I'm pretty sure I should. I'm convert them into DK too. But this is something, a good area for you to get a lot of points through. Demaryius or Emmanuel. Emmanuel, what? Yeah, 11 targets, only 5 receptions.
He loves to throw to Emmanuel.
Yeah, he does, man.
Both of them too, man. He's just trying, he's getting his feet wet. He's just trying to, spread the ball around, keep the receivers happy. But that's what you got to do.
Mm-hmm.
Been off a little bit, but you got to try to get back right here, man. This is the game to get back and try to get you a win, try to score you some touchdowns, and try to carry that momentum on through the rest of the season. But I don't know I don't know what the secondary is going to do this week.
Mm-hmm.
Denver secondary.
Uh-huh. So we have to wait, yeah, let that marinate and see how it comes out over the weekend.
I can't even dissect it, really. I don't know. I'm quite sure Tlaib should be back this week.
Yeah, I don't think they can afford any more losses, especially losing that division game to
Michael Thomas, though. Yes, good thing you put him up. I think he's a legit threat.
He is, man.
He's a legit threat. Like, man. Yes.
Boy got hands, man. He got that hands, man.
He's a legit threat. So, there you have it.
Mm-hmm. All right. Next up, I like this matchup a lot. Chicago at Tampa Bay. They don't have the spreads up yet for Daily Fantasy Nerd, but I'm pretty sure it's already out. Tampa Bay gives out a lot of passing yards. This could be a juicy game for stacking Jay Cutler and Alshon Jeffrey.
Yeah.
Is Eddie Royal out? Or is he just... I think he's going to be coming in.
Well, Cutler and that Jeffrey is Cutler guy, man. You know,
mm-hmm.
I don't know. The season is probably lost, so I know he's gonna probably pad some stats with Jeffrey. That's his guy.
So, yeah.
You know he loves to air it out to Jeffrey.
Mm-hmm.
The Tampa Bay's passing. Offense, defense is not.
That Tampa Bay
run defense is, you know, it's all right, but I really like Jordan Howard. He's emerged.
Mm-hmm.
He's a pretty...
for 6,900 too. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you know, like I said, I like Jordan Howard, but the game overall, Chicago Bears secondary is banged up too, along with a few players over there in Tampa Bay.
Mm-hmm.
Winston said he should be fine. He got nicked up,
mm-hmm.
and I'm not mistaken. Evans got nicked up also.
The running backs are just all injured too. We got Jaquez Rogers with a foot injury, Doug Martin still with a hamstring. So you can play.
And the coach said it's a long shot if Jaquez Rogers could, you know, play.
Peyton Barber.
We're going to have to keep an eye out on Cameron Brate.
Oh, yeah.
You know how much Winston likes to throw to Evans, and if he can get some chemistry with Brate, you know that he'll get a ton of targets too, man.
Especially red zone, man. Red zone. He gets last game he got two targets in the red zone. One of them went for a touchdown.
Yep, so those two guys right there, man, they can be in play. Mike Evans is just... lights out, man. Big time. Whew. He is big time. Did you see that catch? He caught, sideline got popped real hard and kept that ball. He's just, it's like something like he's invincible, man, and then he just pops up, like boom. So it's like, man, he's like unguardable or something like that. I hate to see him on Pittsburgh. On the other side of Roethlisberger, man, you motherfuckers in trouble. But big ups to them being able to hook up. It's his second year?
Yeah, he's doing incredibly well, man.
And he's throwing to him like he's been throwing to him for years, man. So That's some, you know, that's something.
And, 17 targets, dude. Wow.
Yeah, seven. And then what? How many catches?
11 for 150 right. yards.
Crazy efficient, you know.
Whew.
That's crazy efficient. What about Brait?
So Brait, we had Brait with he had 6 targets, 5 receptions, 43 yards with 1 touchdown.
Efficient. So you know what you can expect. You know, when a quarterback gets a new shiny toy, you know what I'm saying? We know what we can expect next week, man. They make for a good triple stack because you can see the trend. You know, once Winston likes someone, he stays locked on them. So that can be a nice triple stack, you know, Winston, Brait, and Evans. And this game could easily turn to something. That's why it probably says no, not available right there, because this game can easily turn to something.
Yeah, know, as soon as Mike Evans, if Mike Evans could clear the concussion protocol, which I'm sure he is, according to Sleeperbot already, it says that he's been limited in the in practices. He practiced yesterday on Monday, so we know if he comes back in, man, that spread's gonna be crazy. So let that marinate. You guys gotta pay close attention.
That's all they're waiting on.
Because it gets they're playing at home too, so it should be a great game. Next off, we got Kansas City at Carolina. Now this will be a very interesting game. Might be a defensive game in my eyes. We got Kansas City against Carolina, 44 over and under, Carolina by 3. So it's going to be a heavy field goal game. Could be a great game for you guys who are on the FanDuel side looking for kickers. As I think Santos got an amazing 14 points. No, was it 14? Last week, he got 15 points.
I love picking that dude, man.
Yeah, him and Vinatieri are just... Gallo used to be that guy too, man.
Yeah, they pick him at home, man. I think you pick Santos at home and you pick Gallo.
Oh, you're right. Especially, this is a great game to choose those kickers from because of these guys are so heavy in defense. Even though, I would like to see how Cam's going to match up against
KC.
Yeah, KC. But for sure, I like that kicking game. I'm gonna who's cheaper? I gotta go with Gano. Let's see if I can fit that in. I think I can. 8,200 left remaining. Oh yeah, for sure. I have still a lot of money.
You probably gotta really think about it. You gotta really think about it for a minute. Those are two good kicks. You gotta think about which one is gonna be the best.
Just gonna give out.
I think
Santos, huh? Because
I think both of them are good options. You just gotta see which one you feel is gonna get the most kicks.
Yeah, you know, this is a very interesting thing too. Having now Davis come right back to the Kansas City. Did you see that?
Yeah. It's a kind of grass, man. Oh God.
Now Davis must be going through some.
Good to be true with a kind of grass last week.
I know, right? I mean, I fade him because I don't trust Foles because with Alex Smith, the read option works better with Alex Smith because he got legs. And with Foles, it's a whole different story. With Foles, it's that guy has an arm. He can actually make plays with his arms. So I didn't go too heavy with Charcantic West, but I decided to go a little bit more with Forte and with Elliott. But this week looks like it'll be a good week for Wes to make his redemption, even though Carolina's D is pretty strong back there with the rushing also. So then, but this matchup is going to be a little bit interesting. I don't think they're going to have Jeremy Maclin. I think Jeremy Maclin's still questionable. What does he have?
And what happened with Kelsey? Did he get ejected or something?
Oh yeah, he got ejected the first quarter. Yeah, God. Yeah, he got ejected like really early. I think it was in the first quarter. Some stupid foul. Both of the players got ejected, I believe.
I didn't see that. I'd that. Imagine he was off to a nice game.
He would have had a nice game. Had, yeah. Had that didn't happen. Now we have to go. We got to go do Finding Kelce now.
But anyway.
Anybody you like from Carolina real quick?
Carolina.
Greg Olsen, possibly. That's the obvious.
Yeah, man.
Kelvin Benjamin, how did he do last night?
Like, I always like Olsen.
Yeah.
He's always in play. Cam is in play. He's in play because of his rushing upside, but I don't know how much I could be wrong. I don't know how much I would have him. If I would even play him, and just my luck, it can bust it wide open.
Kansas City was a physical defense, man. I don't know if that's going to be in his favor after taking all those concussions.
And taking those hits like that, yeah. But, like I said, tight end, what's Olsen? He's always in play, you know.
Yeah.
I like Olsen. What's the total on that game?
The over under is 44. Carolina by 3. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I wouldn't probably be off of everybody in this game. I might have to throw Olsen out there one time for one lineup for safety, but I'd probably be off this game.
Okay. And moving to the next game, we got Miami at San Diego with the over under at 48.5, San Diego by 3.5. Melvin Gordon, man.
JLJ, whatever his name is.
And JLJ. This is nice. This would be a nice running back.
It's emergence.
Uh-huh.
This is what I call this. These two running backs. These guys came out of nowhere and just said, hey, we need to rise up to the occasion. So JJ has been playing awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Melvin Gordon's been playing awesome. Who did the Chargers play last week again?
They played Tennessee, man.
They played Tennessee, and Mariota laid it on the line. Okay.
And I got to give it up for San Diego's defense, too, man. They're playing pretty decent, too.
Yeah, they're playing. They are playing.
Who do you like right away?
Right away on the Miami side of the ball?
Uh-huh.
Jay, he's made me a believer. He's determined. You know, so if they continue, I mean, they don't have a choice, I guess.
No.
They have to give him the ball.
Uh-huh.
And I like him, man. Like him.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I like what he's been doing. He's been showing that grit, you know, that thirst. That's what you want.
24 attempts, yep. That's pretty crazy, man.
Yeah, so, hey, I like that. That's what I would like. If running back come to run, I like that. That's a pick that I can pick. You know, I'll definitely – what's his price?
He is priced at $7,800 off of draft.
Oh, shit.
FanDuel.
This week?
Yeah, this is not DraftKings price, but it's FanDuel price. Melvin Gordon, on the other hand, is – 8,300 also.
They moved on up, huh? That's when you guys started searching elsewhere.
Yeah, they're getting that Le'Veon Bell price now soon, you know?
Yeah, that's when they started flopping. You have to look at the value players that went up too high. But you was able, you know, some of those value players, they come as value players. You ride them up to about, you know, 69, 70, then they start. They didn't went up higher now. Mm-hmm. But they've been performing shit. They've been performing. They done went up to about 83 and shit. Oh, no. But they've been balling, man. They deserve it, you know.
Yeah, they have.
But I know Melvin Gordon does.
Yeah, man. That training with AP was for real, man.
So,
and no Woodhead, so that's good.
Well, you know, Landry, he's always in play.
Do you think it's time? This is where I think everyone's probably going to be really, disappointed. They're really not going to try to choose him this week because of what happened last week. Try to be away from him, try to fade him. Do you think this is the week that he might come back and finally show up? He's going to play against a pretty tough corner. I think it's, I forget his name. It's Peters something. I might be wrong. I forget. But San Diego's top corner is pretty, he's pretty good, man.
And then you got on the other side, I think you got Parker.
Yeah.
So Parker is an interesting play.
Yeah. Four targets last week.
Mm-hmm. He had four.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they was coming off that bye week. And they're not playing that at their normal right now, handing the ball off that this year.
Uh-huh.
Handing the ball off like 20-something times a game.
Yeah.
That's not normal for them right now. But I know it's something they're looking into. Keep doing. And more power to them if they can be successful in it. I'm not too fond of San Diego's run defense.
Yeah.
So I don't know how good they did against. I didn't check his yardage.
Who?
How good they did against Murray?
Oh, Murray. They did a pretty good job against Murray. Murray's
out of end zone or yards period.
Yards period. They kept him down to 51 only.
Right. So I'm wondering, that might have been an easy team to game plan against.
Mm-hmm.
They pretty much do Tennessee. They pretty much do the usual. You know what I'm saying? They pretty much predictable.
Yeah.
But these guys are too if they keep playing the way they plan, but it should be something to see. But I'm still not sold. But big ups to them for holding him down like that, Murray. But yeah. I'm still not sold. They're gonna have to show me more. So for that reason, I do like Ajay.
Mm-hmm.
Be nice to see a battle between him and Gordon. Because yeah, I'm right on the other side of the ball, I like me some Gordon, too.
Uh-huh.
At that price, I will be looking around, though. Mm-hmm. I definitely will be looking around for some cheaper options and things like that. Maybe I might knock on some of the old dogs' door, because I know we haven't gotten to a couple more running backs. So I guess they're coming up. But Parker is somebody you can look into. And on the San Diego side of the ball, as far as the receivers, I don't know what Benjamin did last week, but I've been looking for him. If you see him, it'll be definitely. You tell him, give me a call, man. Definitely looking for him.
Yeah, it's 10:00. Do you know where your players are at? Anyhow,
Gates. Old man Gates.
Gates was, that was the game he finally came through, man. It was perfect. Hunter Henry was out. There's no competition. Boom, punched it in, man.
Yeah. You can see those targets, though. Those targets, he's getting back in the rhythm. Last couple games, mm-hmm. his targets been at least double digits, I believe.
So yeah.
It's good to see old man back in the flex.
It sure is. 75 yards, 9 targets, 1 touchdown. That was pretty good.
Touchdown early, too, right?
Before yeah.
Hey, boom. Get old man Gates a touchdown.
Like, yeah, I had him a lot. I know, me too. I was excited. I was like, yes, man, I got that right. I was afraid because I had it was different. I had stacked Mariota to Gates instead of to Walker. I think Walker did good, too. But I was a little bit afraid. I was like, I might get the wrong guy, get the wrong tight end. But so those are our picks for San Diego and Miami. The next one's gonna be a real interesting one. We got Pittsburgh against Dallas at Pittsburgh. So Big Ben at home against Dallas. This is gonna be a shootout.
Well, I want to speak on the Dallas side of the ball first. I don't know how I let Dez Bryant trick me.
Dez Bryant tricked me too, man.
I always run the Witten, you know, because he's gonna be low on.
Yeah.
Man, I didn't have no shares of Witten, man. He's just catching them in my face, like every catch. He just like he looks at me like,
dude, you believe me now?
Pick me this week.
Can you hear me now?
So like, damn, man, he's just rubbing it in. But anyway, I'm loving the Cowboys. It's good for football when they're doing good.
Yeah.
Hey, it's good for football.
Yeah.
So anyway, going against Big Ben is at home.
Yep. Big Ben is at home. That's a big factor.
That's a big factor. We know how he is at home and away. He's not as good as he is away. So I don't know if that was Russ last week or just his old away game, mm-hmm. him being himself. But he mm-hmm. salvaged a little bit.
He did. And, he did.
I Brown up there into the 20s. I was really worried.
Me too.
I'm like, God, dog it, I'm worried. And then I think Haywood Bay got hurt.
Yeah.
Somebody, and I'm like, man, this is the second half, man. We got to get something. 20, hey, I'll take a 20 any day.
Yeah. So, Eli Rogers, though, man, 10 receptions, 100 yards. 103 yards.
Nice. Very nice. That was very nice. We'll keep up with the status of Haywood Bay or whatever, but yeah. It's on, man. I know they mad.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what can I say? They playing Dallas. I don't, you know, Dallas had been playing I guess they've been decent overall team defense, right?
Yeah, they're all right. They're all right. It's gonna be a tough game.
We're gonna see.
We sure will. I don't think they've met a high powered offense like that, like Pittsburgh.
You know, right now, Dez, every night he calling Dak on the phone like,
keep
look,
it
up. Got Antonio Brown coming in. Don't leave me out there hanging, man.
Yeah, we had our own side bet too. I'll give up my car for your car.
So you know, because hey, Antonio Brown coming in there, he's looking to twerk. Looking to twerk in that.
He will, man. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
So anyway,
it's too bad. You like the stack here?
Neil Brown. Washington defense, run defense, they don't too much scare me too much, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's just they haven't been up against too many. I don't think they played too many super running backs.
Yeah.
But
Bell, yeah.
Le'Veon Bell, he hasn't. I don't think he's wowed me yet, though.
Uh huh.
Since he's been back, maybe one game, if I'm not mistaken, but
mm-hmm.
you know, there's been some injuries and whatnot. So they got to get it together.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, I don't know if I might be.
Could this be the game for you? No, it's still not enough for you.
I might be fading them. I don't know. What's the total on that game?
So that game's gonna be a 49 and a half. Pittsburgh by 2.5, so they're expecting it to be a close game.
On the Dallas side of the ball,
by a kick.
Offensive line is phenomenal.
Oh, always.
He's always in play. Elliott is in play.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I just hate I missed out on Witten. Cause it don't feel the same no more, man. I talk about him every week, but hopefully that's some chemistry, you know. A couple routes, all those routes they nailed last week. hopefully that's a thing to come, because he's sure going to need him.
You know, just to be safe, there's only one player left from that Cowboys offense that hasn't gotten all that love yet. And that's, you know, that boy's name is Terrence Williams. You know, he's been kind of, he's the reason why they're not undefeated.
Right.
Yeah. Because he doesn't know how to step out of bounds.
Yeah, that was crazy, man. That was crazy. He forgot how to play just that quick. And so, they would be undefeated, wouldn't they, man?
Yeah, they would be. They would be. So this will be, it should be a good matchup for him. Dez Bryant will be locked down pretty good.
He ain't caught a pass since, has he?
Yeah. Cole Beasley been
in the back burner. He been in the oven.
I know, man.
But Cole Beasley, he's a target monster too. So, you know. Shucks. It's good though. It's good to see Dak spreading that ball around.
Yeah.
You're going to have to make it. You already know what you got in your offensive line.
Yeah.
Build that chemistry. Like I say, with Dez, don't even force your way in. You're going to get in where you fit in. You're dealing with a rookie quarterback. Don't put no pressure on that man like that. Y'all cruising. He's going to find you. I mean, he didn't found you before. It's a total team effort.
Yeah.
Even if Dez have to be a decoy, it's good for the team.
It's about the win now, man. They're doing so well, and it's not about egos anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so. But it looks like, late breaking news, our new president is going to be Donald Trump, guys.
Yeah.
Donald Trump. It's over now.
Congratulations to him, man.
Yeah, what an incredible presidential year. That has to have taken so much a toll on him. I can't wait to read his book.
Yeah.
When he talks about how he was able to do that, go to every town and everybody wants to kill you. Shit, you better win after that. Or you gotta leave out there. You gotta leave out there with the cops, everybody going at least 60 to 70 miles per hour. And you know, you probably got some fake Trumps in the front too. and you're in the back wearing a hat. in a nice Secret Service suit too, just to be safe, man. but back to the game though, just a little breaking news. Bryce Butler also did come through a little bit also. Oh, never mind. I take that back. He only got one reception. I remember hearing something about him over the game. But Cole Beasley, someone to look at. Antonio Brown, Eli Rogers. I think it was the Colts. I remember they threw a bunch of bombs, man, and just couldn't pull it through. I don't know if it was. I think it was Colts and Wheaton that Big Ben, he just launched it out, and he's like, "Man, I need to get some points on the board." And those are probably weapons that you guys should probably let marinate in you and choose wisely, because they're very cheap and they can have a high upside. $4,900, $5,400, Eli Rogers and Sammy Coates, and even Wheaton, yeah. So these guys, you know, one of these guys, my prediction is one of these guys is gonna hit 20. Just because Antonio Brown's gonna need some, Antonio Brown's gonna probably pull some double coverage. We'll allow one of these guys to just run out there and Big Ben just launch it out at just home.
Gotta nail the right one.
Yeah,
it's a trend.
Yeah, so that's something to look at. But our next game, San Francisco
versus Arizona. The over under is 48.5. I mean 48 points. Arizona by 13.5. This is the chalk game right here.
Oh, the Johnson. Johnson and Johnson. This is game here is gonna be Johnson and Johnson baby powder.
Yeah.
Baby oil and baby lotion. All over there.
You can play Andre Ellington for garbage time.
Yeah.
So expect a big game. Look at this is all orange. I mean, they're hot. JJ Nelson, John Brown, Michael Floyd. You can just stack this game.
All the Johnson, all the Arizona.
Yeah.
He's going to put on, man. Woo! Pick your poison, man.
Yeah, pick your poison. You going to go with the defense? You could go with the kicker, the flex, tight end. I mean, with the wide receiver, running back. Why do they have a flex here on FanDuel side? Last time I remember, FanDuel doesn't have a flex, but I guess it's just there for easy programming. Okay, but
San Francisco is giving up a ton of yards and touchdowns to running back.
Mm-hmm.
And whoever they play, man, plug in your running back, man. They out there like chauffeurs and stuff. They doormans, just come on in.
Yeah, you know? we're trying to get that first round pick.
We
messed up by winning that first game, and Brown seemed to be doing really well in that first round pick. So, but
on the other side of the ball, though, look. Vance McDonald, man.
Oh, yeah. You texted me that Sunday. I was just like, you can't sleep on this guy, man. This guy, if there's any spark left from the 49ers, it's Vance McDonald. He's playing like he wants to give, yeah, he wants that Von Miller money. So, he wants that old Vernon Davis money, man.
Yes, sir. So I got to check the injury. I'm not too up to like with the injury reports with Arizona or San Francisco. But
everyone's good, man. Besides Carlos Hyde, might come back. So that's something to pay close attention to.
Yeah, okay, then that's what we're going to have to pay attention to, that Carlos Hyde then.
Mm-hmm. If not, you can go back with, as a Duwan Harris.
Right, but other than that, I was on cap, I'm not even going to be on cap this week. Had him last week.
Yeah. Oh, did you? Yeah? Nice.
I had him naked in a nice, decent lineup, too. Yeah. I cast off that lineup, I think.
Mm.
I had Kaepernick, couple running backs, about three stud receivers, and it worked out.
Yeah.
And it worked out.
That was a good naked pick, man.
Yeah. He put up some numbers. They played the Saints, right?
Yeah, they played the Saints, man. Saints are a good QB to be naked with, man.
Yeah.
Okay. You could just look at that game. It's self-explanatory. This next one's going to be a nice, nice, nice old rematch. Seattle and New England. Of course, Legion of Boom is not there. Tom Brady's just been having the game of his incredible season.
Incredible career season.
Everything. He's getting ready to go. I mean, he's a legend already, but, man, he's getting ready to, make sure to get that visit this fifth ring now.
He got four rings, right?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, he got four. He's trying to get five.
Yeah, he's gonna.
They coming off. What are they coming off? They're not coming off no bye. They coming off.
I think they did. Yeah, they are coming off a bye.
They coming off a bye, right?
Yeah.
Okay, they're coming off a bye. Fresh. Everybody should be. Everybody should be 100% by now. Gronk should be 100%. He's got to be 100%. I'm calling it. He's 100%. So.
Yeah, I don't see no injuries on their side at all. So. Yeah.
They should be ready to put break out them double tight end sets.
Double running back sets.
So they going against the Legion of Boom.
Legion of Boom. Legion of Boom's gonna
big test for them. It's hard for me to pick and choose who I like out of this game. The over under is they got New England by
49.5 49.5 but they're New England by 7.5
Yeah. And then the over under 49.5
Yeah. Even though I think that's Tom Brady's mindset, I want to get New England 49.5
Yeah. Maybe. I like what I've seen from Russell West.
Russell Wilson.
Russell Wilson.
Surprise.
What's the tight end?
Oh, Jimmy Graham, man.
Did you see
that one hand catch?
Yes.
Whoa. I was in class and I was streaming it on my laptop and he caught it. I slipped out a woo in the class and everyone was like, "Whoa."
This is a game that you can, man. You might, you can be sneaky and go with the double tight end look if you're looking to get some exposure to this game.
Yeah.
Under that Gronk and that, just to, because you never know, man.
That's gonna be a magical game, man. I know it's gonna be, man.
I'm not. Russell ain't no punk.
Yeah.
He ain't gonna be looking to.
He loves it, man. Those guys thrive on this kind of. This kind of environment. So
I don't know when the last time those guys played.
The last time was, I think, Super Bowl.
They played in the Super Bowl.
I think that's it.
That's the last time.
Yeah.
Then,
shit. Yeah, right? Man. And that one still hurts, man. How
Sunday
do you...
Night Hammer 2?
You know it.
No. Only thing they missing is Lynch.
I know, man. Lynch should just come in for that one game. Come on. Just one game, man. Right. Come out of nowhere like Percy Harvin's, right? Just say, out of retirement, man.
How are you going to walk in this locker room with a bag for the Steelers?
Special contract. Yeah, special contract.
No, limit. Right,
I'm all about that action, boy.
How are you going to walk in there and say, give me the ball.
Give me the ball. Did you ever see that interview with him and
Jimmy Kimmel?
Jimmy Kimmel, but the other way where he talks about are you mad that they didn't give you the ball? And he's like, nah. He goes, so you want what made you want to play again another season? He goes, when you play football, it takes a lot of you to do what, to do very well, like how we did that last season, and then to be beast mode, and then you think it's over, and they throw 1500. They throw 15 on the table, and you're just like, damn, I think I could do it again. So he said. He tried it again. It didn't work out. But big shout out to Marshawn Lynch. Thank you for making football fun. You definitely instilled and branded beast mode, man.
He's strong, and yeah, he's strong for walking away like that. That's
top of his career, just getting
sport like that.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you can do it, man. You can do it. Being an athlete, man, you got to be smart, financially smart.
Correct, man. And
especially dealing with a sport like that, you got to be financially sport. Sports in general, man, but you know that you know your career can be ended.
Yeah.
In that sport,
and
they don't make as much money as the rest of the sports. They only play 16, 17 games. They don't make as much as other sports players, other sports, and just got to be smart. And for everybody that's out here watching, playing school, thinking about going pro and all of that, even if it don't even have nothing to do with sports, got to be financially smart, man.
Yeah, financial IQ. They don't teach that in school, man. They don't.
Yeah.
They don't.
But back
to the matchup.
Yeah. This game just has like all over it for me. I just got that feeling for this game. I got that feeling for the game.
We'll give out one our favorite top pick from here. So.
Okay. Yeah.
So who's your must play for if you had to choose a late night slammer?
Okay, in my late night from one of these games, I mean from this game, one of these teams rather.
You can just go with the QBs too, man.
Yeah, you can do that too.
Go naked. I think that might be a good choice because these two are pretty versatile with the ball.
I wouldn't. I'm not gonna take Blunt. It depends on the slate. I ain't even gonna lie. I'm not even Blunt. Maybe depending on how many lines I'm in, but give me some at New England. Yeah, man, you gotta give me some Gronk.
Yeah.
I wanna move them chains. I want somebody active. I'm tired of those hammers that keep missing the nail. I want to move the chains. So
yeah.
Give me some Gronk, man.
Gronk. Awesome. For me, I would go with Tom Brady. Nice. I would just stick in Tom Brady. You know who's crazy though? Deion Lewis is back.
Yeah, they'll need somebody like him in this game.
Yeah, him being elusive, too.
This game more suit him than it's going to suit Blunt. Blunt maybe around the goal line or whatever.
Yeah.
But who knows?
Someone for the yards after the catch. Deion Lewis, James White. Man, they got a bunch of guys that do that incredibly, especially on the wide receiving side. Julian Edelman, Damian Mandola, Chris Hogan, man. I'm always impressed what Brady is able to do with these nobodies, man.
Yeah.
Oh. But so that's that slate, and finally, guys, a nice Monday night game, and I'm gonna have class on this day, man. I wanna watch this game too. Cincinnati against the Giants, and it's gonna be 47 over and under by the Giants, up by 2.5. So Eli and Odell
up by 2.5.
Two and a half. Giants up 2.5. Cincinnati. I find that, well, I guess they're giving the home advantage, I guess. Just the home advantage because, as we know, Tyler Eifert is back, and he came back with a 100-yard game and a touchdown.
Man, imagine that two-game Sunday slate. You got three monster tight ends on the
I know, we got to get...
Monster tight ends. How the hell
you gotta fade the FanDuel and go with DK and get the flex right?
You gotta have Eifert,
Gronk,
and then the other one over there.
You talking about Jimmy Graham?
Graham, and then for the Patriots, you know, Bennett.
Bennett, too, yeah.
And those two-game slates, you know, anything can happen, man.
Like this weekend, man. People, like this Monday.
People going to be firing into that slate. Better, if you want to get into that slate, you better get into that now.
Yeah.
because you all can't see you just making no one liner.
Yeah.
Us degenerates, man, you know, you're gonna be poofing off into that slate, but yeah. But back to this game, I think first of all, I think Cincinnati gonna win this game. Number one.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, Eifert just makes everybody else look so much better.
Yeah.
With Eifert back, now you're looking at
AJ Green being open, LaFell.
You got the running. You got the running game.
Running game. Yeah, you're right.
Both phases of the game, they can pound it, and they got a very nice catching back.
Mm-hmm.
So that the Giants defense, they're gonna be in for something, man. They're gonna be in for something. I mean, I like the way their defensive line was performing last week, but I like Eifert and Green in this one. I can't pinpoint, you know, if on the running back side for Cincinnati, are we stopped?
No, we're good.
Okay. On the running back side for Cincinnati, you got Hill and then you got Bernard. I can't pinpoint which one I'd like.
Yeah, because they get equal attempts and equal shares. They are in the statistics. You can see that last time Bernard got 11 attempts, he got 52 yards, got a touchdown. Jeremy Hill, he got 20 attempts, 76 yards, one touchdown. So they're both almost, it's like 55, 45.
Yeah, when they favored, you know, I tend to go to Hill, especially when they favored by a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And when they projected to be down, I run to Bernard
because
I know he's going to be catching.
Mm-hmm.
When he gets those targets, you know. But this game, that 2.5, I don't see it. I think.
What's your thoughts on Odell?
Oh, on Beckham, Odell, last week I had them stacked, lucky me, but I didn't break the bank or nothing like that. I had them stacked.
Mm-hmm.
They were low owned. It was the day after his birthday or something like that. I kept hearing that, so I'm like, why not?
I didn't even hear about that, man. I didn't hear that until that day it happened.
And all his career stats were just crushing it. On his birthday and after his birthday,
yeah,
like 200 and some yards and this, you know, upper 100 yards and this. So I'm like, yeah, well, let me get some of that. But I think they're gonna need him. I know that much because I just do not believe that they're gonna win this game. We gotta check on the status of Victor Cruz. I don't know what his status is for this week. It might be up in the air. I know he got hurt.
I think his career is getting close to being done, man.
But as for that might open it back up for the what's his name?
Shepherd. Yeah, Shepherd's been incredible, man.
The tight end has been nowhere to be found.
This could be that week too, huh? Because
Because I got them being down. I don't know about that spread. I got them being down. But Odell, I have to look more into it, but I got to like him.
Yeah, that's going to be a crazy primetime game, lights, man.
We got two good games.
Man. Oh,
two
man.
Sunday night. And
they're really expensive. They're all, they're going to be really expensive players, so you're going to have a bunch of cheap guys.
So Shepherd is somebody that, you know, looking at checking into the injury situation with Cruz. Shepherd is a nice cheap pick that you can probably, you know, use.
Yeah.
With Eifert back, who's that on the other? That's on the other side of Green.
LaFell.
With Eifert back, I don't know, man. Ain't no telling with Dalton, but yeah. Dalton, he really loves, you know, I'd imagine he wants to, you know, keep the Eifert thing going so they can be on the same page, mm-hmm. you know, going into these later games of the season.
Mm-hmm. He's such a great red zone target for Dalton too. So,
and on the running back side for the Giants, I'm not on none of those running backs, sadly. But I'm not on none of those running backs. But you know, for that slate,
mm-hmm.
they might come in handy. You know, this game is only in play for me on that Sunday and Monday night slate,
mm-hmm.
or that Thursday to Monday night.
Damn, that's gonna be a tough game, man.
Something. It really gives you something to play for that Thursday to Sunday night.
Mm-hmm.
So, I think my must play out of that group would probably be Eifert.
Yeah. Eifert, I also like Eifert too. I'm agreeing 100% there for that must play. But with that, guys, we are going to, let's see. I wanted to give a big shout out to our Facebook group. Let's see.
There were some guys in the Facebook group that absolutely crushed it this weekend.
Oh yeah, man. Oh, they were in the million dollar lineup. So big shout out to Cortez Martin. He finally got a big win in DraftKings 530 tonight. Incredible. That must have been an NBA lineup possibly.
Mm-hmm.
Rustin Yell got all my money slates for the fifth day in a row. Good job, Rustin.
Good job, Rustin.
305, that's really good. Cash, he barely hit that right there. Boom.
Yeah, that's how I've been living, dangerous like that.
Let's see. So, Eric, big shout out to Eric and them at Draft Shot.
Nice score.
342, that's so high. Gosh, and he did it with Aminu only had two. Oh my gosh, he would have scored crazy. Oh,
he would have took it down.
The one high off. Was like
350 something. No, I think the high was like
360, 370. Yeah, it was like, wow. That's...
Yeah, he would have took that down.
Come on, let me see the one over the weekend because, we're looking at, was it Bam? It wasn't Bam. It was again. Big shout out to Ralph. Big shout out to Freddie too. Freddie, study shows.
Yes, sir.
184. That's pretty good. Winston Elliott.
What was on West salary? If he would have had
San Francisco's running back, he'd be set.
Murray was only 4,000.
Oh yeah. Oh well. Good job to you too, Brian.
Look at McKinnon.
I know, man. McKinnon and freaking Dez. Crockett. So there was another individual on here who hit top 20 in the DK lineup. We're not able to show you, but big shout out to you. We're moving on to week 10. I'll change the background tomorrow. With that, you have anything else would you like to share today, Denzel?
No, I think I have to share this bed.
Yeah, kept you up a little bit longer than usual, but
Thanks again, everybody, for watching. I hope you guys are liking our program. We're trying our best to improve it every week to make it easier for you guys to, you know, learn and gain some value. I am Mangley, and that's my boy over there, Denzel. Oh, this way, yeah. And subscribe, share, comment, check us out on our Facebook page, and we'll see you guys next week.
Yeah, I see if I can get some basketball plays out in the morning.
Okay.
Thing about the basketball plays is, I mean, you got to get them out earlier, or else you won't be able to do your own thing. But value opens up all day long, so you know you have to have the right resources at your hands to do your own research on, you know, injuries and things like that, because there's injuries every day, values open up every day, and things just, like, if I put a video out at 12 in the morning, you know, the same news won't be, I mean, it'll be more news that came out by lock. So make sure you guys stay on top.
That's crazy, man. I can't. That's
every day, man. Every
that means you got to make your lineups like the last hour, right?
Well, that's what I have to, man. You got to soak up information. You can make lineups, though.
Uh-huh.
You can make lineups, man.
Warm up on the lineups, huh?
Not really, man. It's just a few guys you have to look out for, you already know.
Uh-huh.
You know, you just got to watch out for them. I mean, you can dodge them. You can always dodge them, but you want that value that opens up, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
The thing is like those West Coast games, sometimes you just don't know because they lock early.
Uh-huh.
And it's locked.
Oh, man.
You just have to take a chance with that player or whatever. But that's all I want to let you guys know, man.
All right. And with that, guys, we are out. Thank you guys again.
Awesome.